All rise. Court is now in session. The Honorable Shirley Matthews presiding.
Good evening. You may be seated.
Your Honor, calling People v. James Crumbley, case number 22279989FH.
Thank you, Marquise, on behalf of People.
Karen McDonald, on behalf of People.
Good evening, Your Honor. Marielle Lehman, on behalf of James Crumbley.
Mr. Crumbley, can you hear us?
Yes, I can. Thank you.
All right, you can be seated. I want to indicate, first of all, there was a question the media was dying to know about. I'm going to read that into the record. I consulted with the attorneys who answered the question, and so then I sent the question back in. They agreed on the answer. The jury asked, please define Article 16.13, Bullet Number 4, define willfully, neglected, and grossly negligent. The lawyers agreed to answer the question. Please see jury instruction 16.18 for the definition of gross negligence. All other definitions are contained within jury instruction 16.13. I also want to point out that there's a request by the media to ask the jury members if they would be willing to remain in the courthouse and be questioned off camera. Because there would be a verdict and no other defendant pending trial, I would have been willing to do that. But the courthouse closes at 4:30, and I have continually imposed on the courthouse for the sake of this trial and the other one. I cannot impose on the staff or the deputies any further. I also want to indicate that with regard to case number 22279990FH, the People versus Jennifer Crumbley, there is an order restricting pretrial publicity. It was entered on July 14, 2022. That order will be set aside as soon as the verdict is read. I will also be issuing an order that will obviously not be made public in the courthouse until tomorrow morning. In addition, case number 22279989FH of the People versus James Crumbley, the same thing. The order restricting pretrial publicity was entered on July 14, 2022, and that order will also be set aside as of the reading of the verdict. Are you ready for the jury?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, Your Honor.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, I know you've worked very hard. We've all been awaiting your decision. I know this was a very intense decision for you all to make. I believe you've selected a foreperson. Who's the foreperson? You're the foreperson. Could you read the verdict, please?
Each count?
Sure.
count one, involuntary manslaughter, as to Madison Baldwin. Guilty of involuntary manslaughter, as to Madison Baldwin. Count two, involuntary manslaughter, as to Tate Mir. Guilty of involuntary manslaughter, as to Tate Mir. Count three, involuntary manslaughter, as to Hannah St. Juliana. Guilty of involuntary manslaughter, as to Hannah St. Juliana. Count four, involuntary manslaughter, as to Justin Schilling. Guilty of involuntary manslaughter, as to Justin Schilling.
Thank you, poor person. I'm going to ask that Ms. Williams pull the jury. So she's going to ask you each.
Jury in seat number one, was that and is that your verdict?
Yes.
Jury in seat number two, was that and is that your verdict?
Yes.
Jury in seat number three, was that and is that your verdict?
Yes.
Jury in seat number four, was that and is that your verdict?
Yes.
Jury in seat number six, was that and is that your verdict?
Yes.
Jury in seat number seven, was that and is that your verdict?
It is.
Jury in seat number eight, was that and is that your verdict?
It is.
Jury in seat number nine, was that and is that your verdict?
It is.
Jury in seat number 11, was that and is that your verdict?
It is.
Jury in seat number 12, was that and is that your verdict?
Yes, it is.
Jury in seat number 13, was that and is that your verdict?
It is.
Jury in seat number 14, was that and is that your verdict?
It is.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I know how hard this has been on all of you just by reading your face. I know this has been a very hard decision, and we appreciate your time. I'm going to ask you to return to the jury room, and I'll be there with you in a few minutes, all right?
All rise for the jury.
Bond is revoked. Sentencing will be April 9th at 9 o'clock in the morning. All right. I'll allow both sides to speak to the jury if they're interested. All right.
Thank you, Josh.
Thank you.
If everyone can just remain seated.
Thank you.
about the Oxford High School shooting. Yes. He called 911 and said that he was going home to check and see where the firearm was that he gave to his son, the shooter. And the parents told me that was so compelling because when they heard about the shooting, it never crossed their mind that their child might be the shooter and that one of their firearms might be missing.
I put it on the screen right now. We're seeing some people exiting the courtroom. It appears that some of those family members are going the other way.
While we wait for them right now, I'll talk to you about some other conversations we've had with those parents. Just as we were waiting for this the father of Justin Schilling, he told us that today for him is all about accountability. He has been here for every single trial, the trial of the shooter who was found guilty, the trial of Jennifer Crumbley last month.
Adrian Brown is guilty.
He said today, James Crumbley being found guilty, this to him was the final piece to the puzzle. This is something that brings a lot of peace to them. Yesterday, the mother of Madison Baldwin telling our team that every single time these parents have to come to one of these trials, they have to be that they deliberate and receive new pieces of evidence that they are torn in different ways. So, by hearing this tonight, this is going to be able to
really
cooperate with you guys. These families who have just been over so much, and they have been able to do this at control. As you know, the jury deliberated for over 8 hours today, and the attorney for the families telling us that the families were glad that the jury took its time to deliberate because there's no downplaying how historic of a trial this is with this verdict. James Crumbley is now the second parent ever in United States history, the first being his wife Jennifer Crumbley, to be found guilty of involuntary manslaughter for the crimes of their child. I was able to ask some of the parents of some of the victims of the Oxford High School shooting today,
but,
what
does it mean
to them? You know, a lot of times when we have a red people say thoughts and prayers and hear from other people that that's not enough. Well, the parents of some of the victims told me that this to them is a step forward. It's a monumental day here, a historic day in Michigan. We're going to stay live outside and see if we can hear from any of those family members once again. Now I'm going to toss it back to you guys in the stream.
That's right, Tom. James Crumbley hearing his fate inside of the same courtroom where his wife, Jennifer, was also found guilty on all four counts of involuntary manslaughter, one count for each student who was killed more than 2 years ago at Oxford High School. It took this jury more than 8.5 hours to reach that verdict. The jury, 6 men, 6 women, split evenly, some of them gun owners, some of them also parents. As that verdict was read, James Crumbley shook his head. Also in the courtroom, parents of the students who were killed. The mother of Madison Baldwin, her name is Nicole, she wept as the jury foreperson read that verdict. I want to take you back over what the prosecution's key argument was, arguing in part that this school shooting was preventable and foreseeable by James Crumbley. The prosecutor arguing over a course of 4 days, the trial, we heard testimony 5 days, but 4 days, the prosecution brought various witnesses to the stand. 14 of them were the same witnesses we heard from in the Jennifer Crumbley trial, but saying that James Crumbley, who was responsible for storing the gun, could have taken better steps to prevent all of this from happening.
I'm waiting for them to come our way, but we're missing the opportunity to try and help. We're not yet because we don't know where the jurors are. They're not letting them stay in the courthouse. But I can come back.
So he heard that verdict inside of courtroom 2C behind me, and as the jury four-person read the verdict, he shook his head. He pressed his lips together. Behind him were members of, or family members of, some of the students who were killed. Not much more reaction from James Crumbley beyond that. He was led out of the courtroom in handcuffs. He is scheduled to be sentenced in April. In fact, this same week, his wife, Jennifer Crumbley, will be sentenced, and their son, who has been referred to as the shooter throughout both trials, is already serving a life sentence without parole. So while some may call this a victory for the prosecution, a victory for the families, really no one wins. The parents who lost their children that day will never see their kids again. They only have memories. And every time, the families told me, they have to sit in the courtroom and hear the testimony, it doesn't get any easier. A big piece or big piece of evidence was the surveillance video that captured that school shooting on camera time.
Okay, honey.
No problem.
You're welcome.
All right. It's nothing till 8. Let's get off sticks and get ready.
Copy that.
Clear until 8?
Yeah.
Okay. Good to 8?
Yeah.
Let's go handheld now. Stand by me. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Stand by me. I think the video was key. And you know what was key. When did the jury see it? It was like the prosecutor put people before she left it. That shows you how much weight the prosecutor gave that video. That video is crucial. And is it necessary? I mean, if I was a defense counsel, the defense attorney could object to it. Why? Because there's no question that four students would have a show. Here's your whole
message. Can you guys get my programming out of my ear? Otherwise, I'll never be able to hear plus.
Arguably irrelevant. However, the judge allowed him in. Believe me, that's going to be the first thing on the appeal. And they write the appeal to you whenever they write it.
Can I cross?
Yeah. Okay. Effect is far outweighed by whatever good stuff. Sorry. So it's very, very prejudicial. However, the jury was a gentle on this group.
Anything going on where you are?
Well, here comes Karen McDonald.
Oh, you know what? You know, McDonald's coming out now. Okay, bye.
Okay, hold on. Let me just interrupt you for a minute. This is the prosecutor's team walking around right now. This is the
Your press conference in 30 minutes of press results. She's not going to comment right now. 30 minutes.
Hey, folks, yes, you guys are like
there. Where?
Hey, guys, get to the press cross table. Yep. Yeah.
Hi, Devin. We just got word from prosecutor Karen McDonald, who just rolled by us, that they're going to have a press conference at the prosecutor's office in 30 minutes. So we're going to have to get out of this hall relatively soon to get over there. But, you know, I want to talk today briefly about the question that the jury sent over to the judge and to the lawyers today. And it was about the definition of willful neglect. That was what they wanted to know,
fine.
What the judge clearly prior to the verdict being read. But that was the question that they were interested in. So they were citing the definition of willful neglect. And at the end of this trial, clearly they found James Crumbley to have been willfully neglectful. And it was interesting. Because we saw two very different trial strategies. Jennifer Crumbley's attorney.
I can't get you. I got to go. Okay. So what do you need me to do?
neither of them have worked on either of those juries. I don't think stoic is the right word. I think more of a neutral expression. And when he was led out of court, still that same neutral expression. When the judge pulled the jurors, it was clear from what I could see in their faces that this has weighed on them. This was a hard decision. That they took this very seriously, and their voices were shaking as the judge was holding them on whether they, you know, was this your verdict? And they said, yes, it is, to every single one of them. It's going to be interesting to see whether they have
But after the verdict was read and after they released the jury, they could see the emotion on the families' faces as they held the prosecutor's office, members of the prosecutor's office, particularly Cass Dunn. This is a very difficult, obviously, not on top of the tragedy of losing their loved ones, losing their children. They've had to go through this now, not just during the Miller hearing.
It was nice meeting you.
Likewise,
I enjoyed talking to you. We talk again.
The last moments of their children's lives. And they've had to go through it again. When Jennifer Crumbley was on trial, she was found guilty on all four counts, and now James Crumbley has had to go through it again. And you can only imagine just how taxing, but yet, this is the moment that they have waited for. Like some of the parents were telling us earlier today, this is another step in the first was a shooter, and then it was the shooter's mother, now it's the shooter's father, and now they want to school.
Your other gear, Mark, from over there?
Yes.
You know what it is? It's the little microphone and whatever's connected to it.
Yeah.